No way. No way. The police are after me. The police are after me. Flying is dire. I mean, I haven't flown for absolute ages. I think the last time I went flying was like 10 days ago. I know, hectic, right? But check what you can do with the Naviter HYPER. You go up and it beeps. Awesome, eh? Up we go! Up, up and away! Is my ground speed here? Or is it my wind speed? Or my airspeed? I'll have to watch that video again with the windsock. There's some numbers. And here's my climb rate on the left hand side. A red arrow and a blue arrow. Bonus! Twice as good! Check this out. Mental! Yeah! Oh! My last thermal, back that way. How does it know that? Up we go! 1.5 meters a second! Ooh. What's it doing? Why is it beeping? Ah, sometimes it just does silly things. Oh, snap! I think I've just broken airspace. Oh no, man. How am I gonna get out of here? The airspace comes right down to the ground here. I've gotta find the way to get out of here. Do they send out planes or something? Like killer drones? Maybe they send out a helicopter. I'll get chopped up. No way. No way. The police are after me. The police are after me. Look, it's London flipping Gatwick airspace on the screen. Flip, there's all sorts of important things up there, like jets and celebrity YouTubers. I'm gonna hide.
Naviter HYPER. It's pretty cool what it can do. It's got a touch screen, so if I touch here, it'll let me change that field into anything here. It's quite a lot to choose from. You know, altitude, average vario, current glide angle, distance, whatever you want really. You can see I'm going pretty slowly. I think when you're this slow, it doesn't really know what to do because it's expecting you to actually fly. if you're flying around watching these things, you're probably going to fly into somebody, so I advise don't look at the screen at all. Just let it go beep. You got volume buttons on the side here. Let's make it real rockin'. Yeah, it's pretty bright, even in the dark. Down the bottom, you've got a button to navigate through. You've got to press it 1, 2, and then you get to a map. I can't see the police on the map. Maybe they've gone. You can go to another screen and you get a bigger zoom. This one I like to zoom out to show all that airspace that I can break. Look at that. So that's where we are. We're in Gatwick. And that shows you the boxes around it. I don't know how they get all that airspace. I mean, the whole world into this little box. I mean, it's a lot of space and it fits inside there. Anyway, it shows you these red boxes, which is very cool. Except you don't want to be in the red boxes, so that's not cool. You want to stay outside the red boxes. And when the looks like you're going to go into the red box, then it goes red. It doesn't show you what it is. So just stay out of all the red boxes. And it tells you the closest one horizontally and vertically. But you can't see what it is. The next page, you've got a whole lot of settings here. If you're into doing settings on your Vireos, you can do a whole lot of stuff here. Shut down. Oh, that's not going to work. No, it's not working at all. So you've got to keep it switched on. And then it works as a Vireo. Good to remember that. It's very easy to set up these things at the bottom. You can change what information you want to see on the screen. This is enough to show you where you're heading. It'll show you the wind direction and airspeed. It shows you, I've chosen altitude and ground speed because I like to know how fast I'm going. And then you've got your Vireos, and I like to have an averager down there because that's really more relevant to me. I just check at the average and compare that to the whole of the thermal to tell me whether it's kind of tapering off or whether I'm increasing. Then your second screen, I've got a like zoomed in so you can see the terrain. We're in England. There's not a lot of terrain. But this shows you like basic roads in the town and that, and the airspace line. The second map, I like to have like a big view so you can see all the airspace that's coming up. But you know, the screen's pretty small, so unless you really know where you're flying and what area you're in, it can get a bit confusing with this size. It's adequate for simple airspace, just to like avoid the lines and stuff that you know. But I think if you're going to be flying downwind on a cross country with a lot of airspace, you might need to be a bit careful. You're probably going to need a bigger screen instrument. This little guy is very sensitive. I would say hyperactive. Some pilots really love the sensitivity and the way it describes the lift. It has a very steep scale in the first meter, so you're going to find it like do 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 la 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 la. Yeah, you know what I mean. It's quite musical, but it also, it's kind of describes quite big scales in the lift in the first meter. So it takes a bit of getting used to change from something like a flight tech where, you know, you've got like da 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 da. Okay, it's really excited and very musical and chirpy. It sings all over the scale. Once you get used to that, it's very sensitive, very reactive. Every little blip and bump, it will sense something and it'll change its tone. So you can build up a very accurate picture of what the thermal's doing. It's got a little thermal assistant, which is basically a colored track. So you can see the loops in your track. It comes up in the middle here. And that shows you, where the strongest part of the lift is. It's a different color. So it helps you get the best bit of the thermal. That's quite useful. A cheerful, chirpy little unit. A very bright screen. Very small, compact, with color mapping, and a very clear display. Simple airspace with warnings and avoidance. So it'll tell you how to stay out of the airspace. Keep yourself safe.
Come out with your hands up. We have you surrounded.
They don't know I'm in here.
We know you're in there. We can hear your instruments.
Switch it off.
It says Flybubble here on the bag. You that guy with the internet TV channel.
Oh. He's a fan. Yes.
Good, then we want to talk to you about that cloud that you stole.
I don't have it anymore.
It is illegal to take clouds home with you.
Says who?
Says the EU. That cloud was supposed to go to France.
Well, I say Brexit.
Listen here, sonny, don't give me bad attitude.
You're from South Africa.
How can you tell?
It's the only job he could get.
I heard that. You watch yourself. I'm the airspace police, paragliding division.
But I wasn't paragliding, really.
Then why is it in your car?
It's drying out.
Good try. Step out of the car, sir. You're going to the station.
So please, guys, get yourself a Naviter HYPER from Flybubble so you don't break airspace. It'll beep and does all sorts of other cool stuff. For a slightly more technical review, check out our website.